Hey folks, got a short update on the 31 Frigidaire. As you might notice, I did a little cleaning on the cabinet. Looks a heck of a lot better, inside and out. It's got some damaged places that'll need some touch up, but you know, considering how old it is, I guess it's not so bad. Another thing, the cold control throttle cable thing here, it was busted. Well, I found this mower throttle deal at a tractor supply company, and it had enough cable in it to have that much left over and make two brand new throttle cables. Now, the reason those clips are on there is if those wires push up in there too far, it will cause it to get tangled up in here, and I'll take it all apart again. So today I did a lot of insulation work. I didn't video that because it was just really, not worth it. So the original insulation were these panels. And inside there is layers of metal foil. And I'm guessing, you know, it was like a multi-pane window with air trap between them. But most of it was already pretty well like that. And the insulation in the bottom is just gone. That's what this piece came from. And then this was in the sides, the outside of it. And I replaced that. Here's another one of those panels. It's still kind of intact. You can see how deteriorated it is, though. Open it up. It's already like that. So there was just no way around redoing the insulation in this one. So this thin foam board, two layers of that make up for this material. I got that in the sides. And then I got the styrofoam board, and I made a sandwich of several layers of it to replace these panels. And then for the door, this was the door insulation, and it looks just like a cardboard box. And I think it's just hundreds and hundreds of layers of cardboard. It's all kind of not so bad, but on this side, it's going out. And that got replaced with styrofoam also. And I'm going to post pictures of that, but like I said, I didn't feel like doing videos. Now, tomorrow's job is going to be getting these lines flushed out where they're usable again. And to that end, I'm going to loop them together with just a couple fittings and try to run some chemicals through there to get all that corrosion out. I probably should have done that before I did the cabinet work, but, those lines are very intricately bent in there, and if they're bad, it's going to be a worse problem than having to take the cabinet apart again. And turn off my camera light. You may notice that there's a light inside the cabinet now. And I'm holding the camera chest height, and you might barely see it, but holding it at eye level, you don't see it at all. And I positioned it off to the left a little bit, since most of this is blocked by the evaporator. And to control it, right in here is a magnetic reed switch. There's the wires for that. And then I'm going to put this neodymium magnet down there, kind of glue it in place. When it comes over here, it cuts the light off when it's all hooked up. So yeah, that's where it stands today. It looks a lot better with it cleaned up. Now, one thing that's going to have to be done, the door is sitting really low, and you can see up there where the cabinet light's coming out. And nothing is loose in here, but it's like the wood has shifted inside there, so I'm going to have to do some thinking on how to fix that. And tomorrow, I'm going to set the compressor in there take some measurements because these lines are off of the unit that I got the compressor from Travis, and then mine are cut off. So I'm gonna have to get these, everything cut to the right length and solder it back together. All right, that's it for today. Thanks for watching.